with three consecutive victories, and they look to make it four straight tomorrow at home against the Red Wings. Hour five for Barry Melrose and the Melrose Marathon. You're doing 17 hours.
He's still standing. Still standing, everybody.
Still great.
Looking good.
Still great.
Still fresh as
the
day is long.
Yep.
But let's talk about those Golden Knights, because obviously there's been a lot of attention based on what happened in Vegas. Mm-hmm. But how surprised are you that they've made history for an expansion team?
I think I'm very. They were given a chance to be good with the new rules and expansion, and they did a really good job picking players.
As we continue on with our Melrose Marathon, and it's a really cool partnership with ESPN and now A&R for us.
Well, if I'm stuck doing it with you two, I guess I can fit it into my schedule.
Thanks, Kev.
Top plays time. You ready?
I'm ready.
Let's roll it. Let's give you a chance to redeem yourself. Who's your underdog this week?
You know, I'm going to go with the team that's won a couple times for me as an underdog.
Oh, somewhere Matt Berry's going, Sparky! Yeah. You know, quietly, Wisconsin in the Big Ten up to number 7 in the country, and they're favored by, 17.5 over Purdue. How do you see this one playing out?
I like Wisconsin minus the...
Said he was surprised. Maybe he wasn't surprised. He reportedly just bought a condo in Boston looking for a long-term thing there. What could be next for him, Tim?
Well, he'll manage again, I'm sure, if he wants to. He could be a pitching coach again if he wants.
...of this loss, because I've heard everything from it's the most embarrassing loss
it
in
is.
U.S. men's history. Yeah?
Oh, bar none.
Okay.
It's the most embarrassing moment in U.S. soccer history because the amount of resources that U.S. soccer has at their disposal, and I'm not talking about chasing. I was supposed to lead the show. Already, less than 24 hours, John Farrell being fired from the Red Sox, and I'm pushed away. Mm-hmm. That is fundamentally where we are different than the rest of the world, because we don't have any pressure. It's 48 to 72 hours. People will talk about it, but they can go to the grocery store, they can go out to dinner with their significant others, and nobody's going to talk about it. More often than not, they're going to leave. There's a real crux here. And Bruce Arena, the sound afterwards, said what?
We're going to listen to it. I want to play that for you because the U.S. is now missing the World Cup for the first time since 1986. You talk about
playing. That's the population. If they can figure it out, how can we not? It's so disappointing to me because there's no excuses because you have every resource. That says it all.
Got just 12 points in those 10 final games.
Yes.
The previous low? 17 points. That's a huge disparity that we're seeing right now.
Well, hopefully Taylor Twelman will join us later in the show and tell us how he really feels about what happened last night. Honestly, thank you for your
I got to change my pants. I've been wearing these. I mean, I slept
have you
in these
left,
clothes.
Taylor? Go home.
Go.
Go home.
Sleep.
No, I'm
grab
not going
a coffee.
Home. I'll be here all day.
We're just